Welcome, everyone, to the 2021 Greater Los Angeles Area Council Boy Scouts of America Good Character Gala honoring Ambassador W. Robert Kohorst. I am proud to serve as board chair for the Greater Los Angeles Area Council, which serves one of the largest and diverse populations in America. Your support of this event allows us to serve over 15,000 scouts annually. Scouting supports young people in their physical, mental, and spiritual development with an emphasis on learning by doing. This hands-on, values-based approach to learning creates scouting experiences that teach our youth responsibility, character, self-reliance, confidence, trustworthiness, leadership, readiness, and personal honor. This character building throughout scouting programs could not be accomplished without the support of the more than 5,000 dedicated volunteers in the community, one in particular whom we are here to honor tonight on this special occasion. To start our event off properly, a scout is reverent. Please join us for the invocation, followed by a group of our scouts for the opening ceremony.
Please prepare yourself in the manner you're accustomed. Dear Lord, please bless this event and all the people involved with making this wonderful video. Please bless the scouts and their family and bless their friends as well. For food, for raiment, for life, for opportunity, for friendship, for fellowship, we thank thee, O Lord. Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, destiny for all.
On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country, to obey the scout law, to help other people at all times, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight.
A scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, gritty, brave, clean, and reverent.
Say, I am Grace.
I am Grace.
And I am today's scout.
Today I am scout.
Awesome.
A big thank you to our incredible sponsors, Double Platinum Sponsor, Ernie and Gunda Posey Family Foundation. Platinum sponsors are Gail and Jim Ellis, Bruce Davis, Davis Bacon Material Handling Company. Gold sponsors, John Barger, Northcroft's Partners. Andy and Avery Barth. Gary Blazer, Great Western Forum. Kenneth Caldwell. John Johnson, Spartan Group. Brian Matthews, Payton and Rigel. Chris Popovich, Hoffman Foundation. Robert Schooler, Denton's LLP. Nicholas Stonington, The Stonington Group. Please look in our tribute book for the entire list of sponsors for the 2021 Good Character Gala.
Hi from Croatia. Shelley, Bob, I'm really proud of you and really big congrats on your big night. Bob, as ambassador, it was really a challenge, but a successful challenge because now after years, Croatia is in a visa-free regime with the United States. We are on the edge of signing the double taxation treaty. So, Bob, I can tell you that's your big impact in those two areas. So, about you and Shelley as people, as normal people, I can just tell one short story. So, 2 years ago, Shelley and Bob were my guests at my property in the Nature Park of Žumberak. So their security missed the way. So they spent some 5 hours driving around through woods, through hills. And it was really a weird experience. But after 5 hours, they were coming to my reception and they exit the car with a smile on their faces. So that's the real proof that those two are good people. And so I'm really proud I can call you a friend. So I'm raising the glass. Cheers. Sorry not being able to be there with you, but really looking forward to see you soon. Bye.
Oh, hello, Bob. Look, I'm holding that challenge coin you asked me to create when you became ambassador to Croatia. If only this puppy worked in Vegas. Well, as I look at this tastefully designed challenge coin that you so proudly gave to generals, visiting dignitaries, leaders of nations, and Uber drivers throughout Croatia, let me extend my congratulations to you for this richly deserved recognition by the Greater Los Angeles Area Council of the Boy Scouts of America. You know, a challenge coin is often given to honor a person for a special achievement. And Bob, you and Shelley and the Scouts, well, you deserve about a million more of these coins for all the good deeds you've accomplished in your personal and professional life. Now, so many, in fact, that if you used your own merit badges versus challenge coins, you would have earned enough to cover every square inch of a Boy Scout uniform, not simply the sash. Bob, it really was Croatia's lucky day when the ambassadorships were handed out. Your business acumen and your out-of-the-box thinking made you the perfect choice for Croatia's goal to improve the economic well-being for all of its citizens. Which leaves all of us in this room asking the obvious question, what's next? I mean, what does an ambassador who's retired do when all the books have been written and all the files erased? Well, here's the inside scoop. Netflix has just greenlit a screenplay that Bob penned while tanning himself on the Adriatic Sea. It's called Friplomacy, the movie, the burger, the Bobs. And our Bob's acquisition efforts to bring Bob's big boy to Zagreb went global, and it inspired Netflix to produce a series that brings the original double-decker taste of America to a nation tired of yet another bowl of Game of Thrones gruel. By the way, the first episode is being shot in the capital, formerly known as Zagreb, as we speak, and Bob has just changed that name to Zagreb. So Bob, we know you'll nail it and circulate even more challenge coins earmarked for the Scouts. Well done, my friend. Richly deserved.
Hi, Bob. It's an honor and privilege to be here today to talk about your goodwill and kindness to the community and to our country. You know, I've known you for a number of years, over a decade, and our friendship has blossomed and grown by leaps and bounds. We've had some very interesting conversations, and you've taught me a lot. You've actually been a mentor, and you've acted as like a big brother to me, and I appreciate that. You know, I always wondered during our relationship how you were so calm and seemed to have such a tranquil life. You just were so happy. I saw you help other people, families, institutions, and I wondered, gosh, what's his formula? What's his recipe? And one day, you emailed to me a list called the Cohort's Priorities. And what you had me do was to look at one in particular. That was number 6. It was to give back to the community by time and money. As a law enforcement officer over 27 years on the department, that really resonated with me because at times it's been challenging being on the department because you give and you wonder what you get in return. But you, I saw you doing that every day, day in and day out, and your life seemed to be again filled with happiness. It made me go back to why I wanted to be a police officer. And now I'm in homicide, I help other people. I go back to my community and I give back at my alma mater, LaSalle High School, as you do. And I've seen you help, again, people within that community. It's just been a great ride with you, learning from you, and trying to mirror the things that you do. I appreciate what you've done for our community, day in and day out, and the fact that you and Shelley, your wife, have just recently returned from Croatia after serving our community, our country actually, for a number of years, giving up your family, your grandchildren, to serve our country. So I thank you for that. I have this brand I'm thinking about, called the Cohort's brand, which talks about, to me, character and integrity. And those are characteristics that you live day in and day out. And you've been a great example to me and many others by bringing that out in us. behind any great man, there's a great woman. And that's Shelly Cohorse. So thank you. Go Team Cohorse.
Congratulations, Ambassador Cohorse.
Tonight's event has been chaired by Andy Barth. Andy is here to tell you more about our honoree.
When you consider Ambassador Cohorse's lifetime achievements and civic duties, it's easy to see why he is so loved and respected, not just in the community, but all over the world. Bob served as the U.S. Ambassador to the Republic of Croatia from 2018 to 2021, serving as the Chief of Mission at Embassy Zagreb. At the conclusion of his term, the President of Croatia, with the concurrence of the Prime Minister and the Minister of Foreign Affairs, presented Ambassador Cohorse with the Order of Duke Branimir Medal for excellence in promoting international relations. Bob is the founder and CEO of Everest Properties, based in Pasadena, California, and currently is an advisor to the company. Bob grew up in Pasadena, California, and attended LaSalle High School, graduating in 1971. Ambassador Cohorse holds a BS in accounting from the University of Dayton, summa cum laude, and a JD from the University of Michigan Law School, Order of the Coif. Bob has been recognized for his contributions to public service organizations and education as director and past chairman of the Young Presidents Organization, San Gabriel Valley Chapter, regent of Loyola Marymount University in Los Angeles, California, trustee of LaSalle High School in Pasadena, California, and director. Bob served as past president of the San Gabriel Valley Council, Boy Scouts of America, and has stayed engaged with scouting after merging with the Greater Los Angeles Area Council. He is married to Shelley Allen, and they have two adult sons, Kevin and Matt, both of whom work for Everest Properties. They also have two grandchildren, William and Charlotte. The entire family is passionate about sports, particularly skiing, basketball, football, baseball, tennis, and golf. When I think of Bob Cohorse, I think of a man who fulfills his duties, who's committed to the public service, who could not be a better recipient of the Greater Los Angeles Area Council's Good Character Award.
Congratulations, Ambassador Cohorse.
Hello, I am Jeff Salzbach, Greater Los Angeles Area Council's Scout Executive and CEO. We are pleased to honor Ambassador Cohorse, someone who has done so much for scouting over many, many years. You may not know that Bob was never a Boy Scout, but I think he has more than made up for it through his service to scouting and to the community. If Bob had been a scout, no doubt he would have earned plenty of merit badges. When I look at the list of merit badges, I picked out a few that seem like the ones that Bob would have earned. These include American Business Merit Badge, Entrepreneurship Merit Badge, Family Life Merit Badge, and the Law Merit Badge. Of course, there's no doubt that he would have earned the Sports Merit Badge and the Golf Merit Badge. And a service to the community would have earned him the coveted Citizenship in the Community, Citizenship in the Nation, and Citizenship in the World Merit Badges. Proceeds from tonight's event will help bring scouting and merit badges to more than 1,500 new scouts over the next 3 years. The Cohorse Allen family and all of you have helped to launch a 3-year Scout Me In campaign to bring scouting to the next generation of young people. To tell you more about how scouting changes lives, I would like to introduce you to an extraordinary scout. Andrew Custodia took the merit badge program to heart and earned every merit badge that a scout can earn. That's over 135 merit badges, ranging from the American Business Merit Badge to Woodworking. These badges allow scouts to explore career fields such as nuclear science or the trades such as welding. And of course, there are still the classics like Camping and Pioneering Merit Badge. Andrew graduated from Glendora High School in 2020 and is currently studying at Cal Poly Pomona, majoring in Aerospace Engineering. He is part of a special class of scouts who have earned every merit badge. In fact, there are less than 500 such scouts out of more than 2 million Eagle Scouts. Here to tell you more about his scouting journey is Andrew Custodia.
So the first merit badge I earned was Inventing. I earned it at a merit badge day. We basically went to another troop's event and I earned the Inventing merit badge. I forgot my counselor's name, but it was back in February of 2012. The most interesting merit badge I think that I earned was probably Wilderness Survival. As it was something I did at long-term camp, but it was very interesting because one of the requirements is you have to spend a night in the wilderness without a tent. And I thought that was really fun to do with, I did it with a couple of my friends in, that were also in Scouts. So I thought it was really interesting to do that merit badge. I had a lot of fun doing it as well. Most challenging merit badge is probably swimming, not because it was difficult. I knew how to swim. It was more of the endurance aspect of it. There's a lot of, you have to test a lot of your different strokes and different swimming techniques all at the same time. So it was very challenging for me to have the endurance in order to complete all the like various, I think it was about 16 laps in the pool. It was very tiring. Something I hope that my brothers and sisters get from scouting is being able to effectively communicate, because I think that's very important in today's world. Communication is everything, coming from teamwork to leadership to just working in just the current environment that we live in. Being able to effectively communicate and have those skills to portray your thoughts effectively, that is very important. I hope that they can take that away, because scouting does a great deal in showing you what mistakes you make when you're communicating, because maybe sometimes things don't come across the way you meant them to. And being able to learn how to do that through scouting, through even my Eagle project that helped me just figure out how to communicate things, just all those different kinds of things, I hope that they will be able to learn and take that into the world. My name is Andrew Kasodia, and I am today's Scout.
Becoming an Eagle Scout takes planning and persistence. It also helps when your family is totally into scouting. Andrew's family is one of those families that is all in when it comes to scouting. I'm pleased to introduce you to the Kasodia family.
Well, being a scouting family to me, and I think as well as my wife, is just having an adventure. You know, it's an absolute wonderful adventure. We've always said from the beginning that we're going to introduce the kids to a lot of things, and scouting just does that for you automatically. Simply just through the merit badges, through the Cub Scout program. We went through the whole program. We were fortunate enough to join together, and then we've seen all our kids go through the program, and it's been a wonderful and continues to be an amazing adventure. Something that we'd like to share with other people, and then so that they can see what they're capable of. I mean, it's just amazing.
And it's been really fun, you know, getting to do things with your siblings. Like, I remember taking a lot of merit badges with like my older brother, and we got to work on them together. We got to sit in the same classes. So it was a good experience for both of us.
My favorite scouting memory would probably be when I took my first merit badge lesson, because I was kind of scared of like, oh, I have to fill out this entire packet. I was kind of worried, but it turned out to be very easy.
So, what's the most fun you've had with scouting?
Halloween stuff.
And what's your favorite game?
Ring toss.
What do you look forward to being able to do in scouting?
Do Pledge of Allegiance.
Ooh, the Pledge of Allegiance?
It's very valuable when, like, you can walk up to another kid when you're meeting them, or a fellow classmate, and you're just able to, you know, like, be helpful, be kind, be cheerful, and all that sort of stuff. So when you're meeting other people and meeting new people, and when people meet us, they know that we're a scouting family and we have those ideals instilled in us. So
they're in Taekwondo, they're in so many different things, they're in band, but nothing like scouting exposes them to those safety first, adventures that test their character and test their resolve. And you can't get that from anything that I've seen, that we look for those kinds of things, and scouting gives you that over and over and over again.
We are the Kasodia family, and we are today's Scouts.
Before we present the Good Character Award to Bob, we'd like to hear from a few of his friends and family.
Hi, I'm Los Angeles County Supervisor Catherine Barger. It is such a privilege to join you in celebration of the Good Character Gala. As a supervisor and as someone who grew up surrounded by Scouts in my family, I have a special place in my heart for BSA. Being a scout teaches our youth the importance of doing their part and being people of strong character. Scouts are trustworthy, kind, loyal, helpful, and so much more. I've been fortunate to see this play out in our community and in my family firsthand. And of course, I've seen these characteristics in our honoree, my dear friend, Ambassador Robert Kohorst. Ambassador Kohorst is remarkably generous. He is defined by his good character and dedication to making a meaningful difference. In his community, and even across the globe, Ambassador Kohorst's commitment to public service uplifts, encourages, and equips scouts for the future. Ambassador Kohorst not only believes in scouts, but served as a past president of the San Gabriel Valley Council. I am grateful for your compassion and support for our youth and this organization. Thank you, Ambassador Kohorst, and your wife, Shelley, for investing in the next generation. You both display true leadership and instill hope in the lives of so many young people. Congratulations on this well-deserved award.
Congratulations, Mr. Ambassador and Shelley, on this tremendous honor that you're receiving tonight from the Boy Scouts in Los Angeles. Your support of the Boy Scouts is literally ensuring America's greatness in the future. Lomri and I are the parents of an Eagle Scout and two Girl Scout Gold awardees, and we know how important these lessons are that our young people are learning in scouting and how they're going to take those lessons and become America's future leaders. When I was the President's National Security Advisor, I could always count on you as our ambassador to Croatia. You had tremendous accomplishments in the Balkans, including keeping a key port in Croatia out of the hands of our adversaries and in the hands of our NATO allies. Thank you for your service to our country there. But through your philanthropic efforts, you and Shelley continue to serve our country. You're serving our community, you're serving Pasadena, you're serving in Los Angeles, and you're serving the people of California. So thank you for your efforts, Bob. This is tremendous. Tonight's recognition of you and your wife and your family and your company is well-deserved. God bless you, Mr. Ambassador. God bless you, Shelley. God bless the Boy Scouts of America, and God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
They've only given me 30 seconds, so I won't repeat the universal praise from the other speakers about Bob and Shelley's generosity with both their time and money to help our community and our country. Rather, I'd like to focus on Bob's almost infallible ability to spot a business opportunity and capitalize on it. Bob is truly one of those guys who skates where the puck is going, and he has a near perfect record. A near perfect record. However, there was one misstep. It all began with a divine inspiration in the middle of the night as Bob woke Shelley from a sound sleep with the exclamation, "I've got it." This idea will take us out of this rental dump into the big cottage behind the Huntington. "What's the idea?" Shelley asked as she jumped out of bed, ready to begin packing for their imminent move. Shelley knew that Bob was a big thinker, and whatever it was going to be big. "I've noticed," Bob said, "that there are millions and millions of naked dogs out there, and I bet all of their owners are looking for the perfect costume for their dog." And thus was born the Kohorst Dog Costume Company. The focus was on dogs because, as Bob so astutely pointed out years later, everybody knows that cats and hamsters would look silly in a costume. As he explained the business plan in detail to Shelley, she climbed back into bed. Finally, as Bob droned on and on, she rolled over and said, "Bob, take some Pepto-Bismol. The pizza has given you indigestion and your brain has stopped working." For those of you out there who may still have a naked dog and are looking for the perfect dog costume, I suggest you talk to Bob. I know he still has a few boxes of costumes in the garage behind the big cottage at the Huntington, and they will be deeply discounted. Thank you, Bob and Shelley, for everything you have done for your country and for our community.
I would say that Bob embodies all the traits of a Boy Scout, and that's what's made him so successful. But I'd have to add two more. The first one would be challenging, and we've had our challenges in our life, but he always challenges you to be the best you can be, and I think the boys would agree with that. And the second one is generous. He's always kind with his time, his love, and his life. So thank you, Bob. It's been a wild ride, and I love you.
We honor a true community leader who has done so much for our community and country over the past decades by giving of his time, service, and commitment. Good character sums up our honoree. Good character does not mean perfect, but rather human, caring, and sometimes involving some sacrifice. Perhaps that sacrifice is serving one's country by relocating overseas for 3 years for an important position appointed by the President of the United States. A person with good character matched with leadership skills is a powerful force, and it is rare and getting more uncommon in today's society. A good character is a person that any parent could use as an example to hold up for their community, their schools, their church, and their children. Scouting not only promotes good character and leadership, but also attracts it. Let's now turn our attention to the honoree. We are all here to celebrate tonight. But first, let's hear from our 2020 Good Character honoree, Chris Popovich, and see if he has any words of wisdom for the 2021 honoree.
Bob, my only advice to you is you have some big shoes to fill, because I'm a tough act to follow. I'm not so sure if Shelley would agree. If anyone has earned it, my friend, it is definitely you. Congratulations.
So, Good Character Award. Actually, I'm here to talk about Bob Cohorst. You know, in his early days, he wanted to be a high flyer. So he went to the University of Dayton, where they are the Flyers. That just didn't work. Then he decided to go to law school at the University of Michigan, go blue. Became a law clerk, and then an attorney, and then an investment banker. So this is where his riches to rags to riches life began. From the riches of investment banking and real estate, he started a downward path, which involved a golf club company that is who knows where, a bond arbitrage business that went away, a Halloween costume company that disintegrated, a dog costume company. Are you starting to see the rags part? Back into real estate, riches, and finally, a high flyer, our ambassador to Croatia and a true philanthropist. It's been a great ride. Your friends, all of us, have loved being on it with you, and congratulations on this very well-deserved honor, Mr. Ambassador.
Congratulations, Bob!
Hi, I'm Kate.
I'm Jenny.
And we're here to talk about Bob.
Bob.
So I'm Bob's daughter-in-law.
Soon-to-be daughter-in-law.
And we want to talk about Bob and how he embodies the Scout's 6 characteristics. And I guess I'll start first. So I met Bob a long time ago, 17 years ago, I think, to be exact. And Bob was very, very quiet around me at first. I think it's because he grew up with 4 brothers. And he was convinced that me and my husband were going to have all boys. So the first that came around was William, and he was just so excited when William came around. And he would come over almost every day to check on his grandson, William. And William and him were just like 2 peas in a pod. They got along so well. And William was potty training. He was in the middle of potty training. And this is like when FaceTime was just really getting hot on the market. And William decided that it was a really great idea to FaceTime Bob and tell him about what he had done. So we called Bob up on FaceTime, and Bob answers. And he's in the middle of this like big important meeting. And William, with his 2-year-old grin, goes, Bob. And Bob goes, yes, William. And he goes, I went poo-poo in the potty. And Bob's face goes bright red. And he goes, well, congratulations, William, in the middle of this huge important meeting. And I guess what I'm trying to convey by this message is that he is loyal. Like whatever he's doing, wherever he is, he will drop whatever he's doing to connect with his family. It doesn't matter if he's in the boardroom, if he's playing tennis, if he's dealing with diplomatic people across the nations, he will always stop what he's doing to make sure his family is okay, and I'm really grateful for that. He has not shown up to one of my tennis practices yet. They're at Wednesday at 9, Bob, so if you want to see, they're right there. But he has always been there for my kids, so I'm grateful for that.
My two words for Bob, when I think of Bob and I think about the Boy Scout characteristics, I think of courteous and I think of kindness. So when I first met Bob, my then boyfriend's father, it was in Croatia, and I was very nervous to meet Bob and Shelley, but they both welcomed me in as if I were their own right away, and they were very warm and friendly and courteous, and of course the family embodied those traits because Bob passed them on to his kids and his grandkids, and so those are the first two things that come to mind when I think of Bob. He's not only kind to me, but my family and everyone he comes in contact with. And it's something I really admire about him. So that's what I think of when I think of Bob.
An example of our dad being loyal would be, as a kid, he would show up to every one of our sporting practices and events. And it was great to see him and our mom there supporting us and showing their loyalty by supporting us in everything we did.
And one way our dad was kind was during Little League practice or games during the season, he would always play every player the same amount, regardless of skill level, regardless of wins or losses. It was about everybody on the team having a good time and wanting to play, wanting to be there. And that's the best example I can show of his kindness.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is a special pleasure to be able to participate in paying tribute to Ambassador Robert Cohorst, who is being honored by the Greater Los Angeles Area Council Boy Scouts of America for the Good Character Award. I have known Ambassador Cohorst, my dear friend Bob, and his wonderful spouse Shelley for a number of years now. I was the president of Croatia when Bob served as ambassador of the U.S. to Croatia, and I must say that he went well above and beyond the call of duty in order to promote friendship and bilateral relationship between our two countries. Congratulations, Bob, and all the best to you and your family.
Cap 91, congratulations, Ambassador Cohorst.
Ladies and gentlemen, our 2021 Greater Los Angeles Area Council Boy Scouts of America Good Character Award recipient, Ambassador Robert Cohorst. Congrats, Robert.
Thank you, John. It's a real honor to receive this award. Go Scouts.
Congratulations, Ambassador Cohorst.
Dobry vecher. I am Bob Cohorst, the former and most recent U.S. Ambassador to the Republic of Croatia, and more importantly, a huge scouting supporter. Thanks for joining us this evening. It is an absolute honor to receive the Good Character Award from the Greater Los Angeles Area Council of the Boy Scouts. There are many deserving individuals, and I am pleased to even be considered for this award. I was introduced to scouting as a child, although I never moved past Cub Scouts. I was reintroduced to scouting more than 25 years ago by a good friend, Bill McDonald. Bill was active with the San Gabriel Valley Council for many years and asked me to participate on the board. The more I learned about the scouting program, the more I became interested in helping the organization serve the youth of our community, especially those who were from disadvantaged backgrounds. I served on the board for many years, including two terms as council president. I have seen firsthand the exceptional job that scouting does developing our youth for the future, and I believe it is in the interest of society to make this wonderful program accessible to all youth, regardless of the ability to pay. Most recently, my wife, Shelley, and I have supported new outreach programs in less advantaged neighborhoods. These pilot programs have been largely successful, and it has been gratifying to see the scouting message reach a new and deserving demographic. We don't need more government to make society better. We need more scouts. We live in turbulent times. Many of our institutions are struggling to find their best purpose and mission. Disagreements are now emotional, not reasonable negotiations. In all of this disarray, it is great to see that the Scout Oath and Scout Law remain as relevant today as when they were adopted years ago. How can anyone in good conscience not embrace the oath to do your best for God and country and the law, to be trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent? Thank you to all of the scouting staff and volunteers who make scouting possible. And special thanks to Gala Chair Andy Barth, Jim Ellis, Scout Executive Jeff Sulzbach, and the entire host committee for your tireless efforts in making tonight a success for scouting. There is a lot of good character going around. I hope our gala can raise money and awareness to allow the Scouts to continue serving our communities, and especially those most in need, through our Scout Me In program. Havala Liepa.
Congratulations, Ambassador Cohorst.
It's us, and today we are going to be talking about
Bob.
So I guess I'll go first. So one thing I love about Bob is that he's always there for me, and he always does what I like, and he's always does sports with me, which I really like, and he's also very nice with me. Whenever I want to do a sleepover, he does.
I like Bob about because he lets us take sleepovers, and when we ask, and he says yes, and whenever William calls him, and he answers, and William says he wants to play golf or tennis, and he says yes or no, and then he plays with William, and then when he's done, I play with him sometimes too.
Ambassador Cohorst, you are a great scout and most deserving of the Good Character Award. Thank you for allowing us to honor you and for your dedication to young people across our communities. And finally, thank you all for joining us for the virtual Good Character Gala. This has been an incredibly successful event for Greater Los Angeles Area Council, and more incredible for the young people we serve. Together, we are changing lives and developing tomorrow's leaders. The Good Character Gala has raised thank you to our generous sponsors and supporters, and thank you for helping to build character and leadership in today's youth who will be tomorrow's leaders. Thank you.
Thank you.
2021 Greater Los Angeles Area Council Boy Scouts of America Good Character Award recipient, Ambassador Robert Kohorst. Robert, congratulations. Yeah, yeah. Probably want to do that one over again. Yeah. Let me catch you. Yeah, yeah. It's going to be on it. We're going to show that Wednesday night.
Bob, look, I'm holding that challenge coin you asked me to create when the teleprompter didn't work that day. You remember that, Bob? And Bob, you and Shelley and the Scouts deserve about a million of these coins for all the good deeds you people have accomplished. People? That's actually really bad. That's bad.